Dear Kuwait television viewers, thank you for joining us with our special program. And this time we have a new guest, the visiting Minister of Culture and Minister of Tourism, His Excellency Abulfas Garayaf. Your Excellency, Minister of Culture and Minister of Tourism, welcome to Kuwait and thank you for joining us with this special program.
Thank you very much. It's my honor and pleasure to be here in Kuwait, and I would like to thank the authorities of the Ministry of Information and of course the leadership of the Kuwait TV for the opportunity to meet and to tell something about our country. Thank you very much.
Your Excellency, first I would like to ask you, can you tell us what Azerbaijan means and what can you tell us about Azerbaijan?
The meaning of the name of the country is coming from the very ancient times because this is the transcription of the meaning the land of fire. Azerbaijan, Azerbaijan, and it is coming like from the ancient languages of the people living at that time. And it means the land of fire. You know that Azerbaijan is the country which was always famous for the oil and gas. And the first industrial drill and first industrial excavation of the oil started in Azerbaijan, the city of Baku, in 1848. Since that time starts the beginning of the oil history of the mankind. From this point of view, the name Azerbaijan is coming from the impressions of the people who were traveling across this road, traveling in Azerbaijan, go on the Great Silk Road from Europe to China, bringing goods, bringing a lot of products to sell, to buy. And they saw a lot of flames coming from the surface of the land, from the mountains. And they said, this is the land of fire. And name Azerbaijan is coming from the name land of fire. Even today, there are some state preserved in the country where you can see the same situation. You can throw a stone to the small hill and the flame of fire will come from that.
It's very interesting to know that, you know, Azerbaijan was the first where it had the oil drilling. Yeah. That's interesting. Can you tell us about, Your Excellency, the culture of Azerbaijan?
As I told you, the country is situated on the crossroad of the civilizations. All caravans bringing goods from the ancient time on the Silk Road, the road which was connecting northern territories to the southern territories, were passing nearby the Caspian Sea on the road which was very convenient for traveling. And due to that, Azerbaijan was always the place which attracted great interest of the different nations, different countries. We passed several big historical events through our history. Azerbaijan was the country where first human beings were starting to live. Today in Azerbaijan you will find the Gobustan State Preserve, where you will which is inscribed in the UNESCO heritage list, where you will find inscription on the rocks, paintings of the animals, dances, boats, people which are inscribed and painted on the rocks by people, by artists who were living there starting for the period from the 40,000 years ago. And this is the place which reflects the history of the mankind. The travelers, the different tribes coming to Azerbaijan brought their own cultures, brought their own influences. And I can tell you that Azerbaijan, due to the name of the land of fire, was one of the sacred places for fire worshipping. Zoroastrianism was, Zoroastrians were coming to the country to pray. Today in Azerbaijan you will find a temple of Zoroastrianism, which is reflecting our respect to the fire, to the tradition, and to the history of our country. Azerbaijan is the country which accepted first Christianity in the region on the first century. And on the 8th century, Azerbaijan people, the inhabitants of this territory, accepted Islam. Since that time, we are following all the regulations of Islamic religion. Azerbaijan today is one of the very active members of the Islamic Cooperation Organization. It is the country which is strictly coordinates with and cooperates with the ISESCO. ISESCO is the cultural organization of the Islamic countries, and now Azerbaijan is in the position of the presidency of the General Assembly of ISESCO. The cultural system of Azerbaijan is very variable. You can find the expression of the modern art, you can find a traditional architecture, you will find a modern architecture, and you will of course find a lot of talented people who are creating, doing beautiful examples in music, the composers, the singers, the dancing, national dancing, which is another special school which were created during centuries. We have inscribed in UNESCO intangible heritage list such kind of things like tradition of viewing carpets in Azerbaijan. The carpets in Azerbaijan is something which is living with us all our life. When the child is born, it's usually born in the place where carpets are existing. And when we're taking to the last trip to the other world, to the real world, men or women, it's again going in carpet. So I think that the carpet is something reflecting the mentality of our people, the tradition, the art. And today in Baku, in the capital of Azerbaijan, you will find the biggest in the world museum of carpet. So we have very interesting presentations. Every year we have different festivals, different international competitions of musicians, of artists, biennales. And I think that for the modern world, Azerbaijan is the place where, as many centuries ago, different cultures are coming together and they know each other better, they understand each other better, and the traditions of multiculturalism, different cultures in one state, is very important asset for the country of Azerbaijan.
Yes, actually that is very interesting to know that Azerbaijan holds various multicultural people and backgrounds. That's very interesting. Your Excellency, could you tell us about the most popular, it might be difficult, but the most popular like things or places in Azerbaijan or cities of Azerbaijan?
You know, if we would talk about the country in general, we will find a lot of places to of interest to go. But I can say that every tourist, potential tourism who is going to come to Azerbaijan will find something which is reflecting his expectation. What do I mean? If, for example, you are looking to see the part of Europe, European culture, European tradition, you will easily find theaters, ballets, dancing, cinemas, shopping arcades. You will find a lot of city life style which is reflecting the modern development of the country. If you are looking for something very historical, very traditional, then you will find the pearl of Azerbaijanian culture and the pearl of Azerbaijanian, let's say so, architecture, the old town within the, this is the town within the city of Baku. The history of the city of Baku started in this place, and it is preserved and it is enlisted in the list of World Heritage of UNESCO. Behind the walls, you will find old buildings, the style of life, which smoothly goes in traditions of the Oriental country, and you will find the oldest mosque in the Caucasus region, in Shamakha region. You will find the biggest mosque which is constructed recently in the city of Baku, the biggest mosque in the region. This is Haydar, the masjid we call it, the Masjid of Haydar. This is the city of Sheki, which is the mountainary, let's say so, small paradise, because the weather there is always smooth, cool, the life is very positive, smiling, a lot of jokes, a lot of good meals, but the style of life is very traditional and very creative. The other thing that Azerbaijan has 9 out of 11 existing climatic zones. So you can find the variety of these climatic zones. If you are looking for the hot weather, you go to the seashore, enjoy the sun, the beach, the sea. If you are looking for the cool weather, you are welcome to the mountain ski resorts, which are situated on the level of the until 2,000 meters in the mountains. It's always cool, it's always green, and very attractive. I consider that for potential tourism from your region, there will be a lot of traction for the family tourism. Family tourism is something which is reflecting the interest of different ages, different, let's say, so family members. For ladies, big shopping malls, big entertainments, museums, art galleries, small boutiques, and for the men, a lot of competitions, small cafes and restaurants to sit, to relax, to enjoy the time. For children, there are entertainment centers, sports events, sports facilities. Each of them will find a lot of attractions which will reflect their expectations and will of time spending. And of course, plein air. I know that people from Halij region likes to go to the regions where it is cool, where it is green, and we have a lot of forests situated within 1 hour drive from the Baku. We have very good alpines where you can sit there and enjoy the time. So it's better to see than to, you have to feel it, feel it.
Your Excellency, as far as I know, the Azerbaijan will be holding an international forum. With the UN. Could you tell us more about this UN forum?
As I told you, the tradition of multiculturalism in the country are living for centuries. Mm-hmm. And these traditions are living also today. This year in the country, announced by the president of the country, the year of multiculturalism. What does it mean? It means that every nationality, every small nation, even small nationality which is living in only one village in the mountain, but they speak their own language, they speak their own tradition, they live on the way they used to live for centuries. They are part of Azerbaijanian culture. This is the multiculturalism. We respect that. We held a special events for them. We make possible for them to fulfill their artistic potential, to show their tradition, and with that to bring the understanding and the belief that different cultures, different traditions can be together and be peaceful and coexist with each other. From this point of view, we initiated even today the big contacts between European cultural institutions and Islamic Council of Institutions. Azerbaijan today is the member of Council of Europe, and Azerbaijan is at the same time the member of OIC. It means that we are linking. First ever, when Azerbaijan was capital, Baku City was announced the capital of Islamic culture, at the opening ceremony we invited guests from the European culture capitals, and vice versa. Since that time, we have ministerial meetings, we have round tables, we have big conferences concerned with the role of youth in the intercultural dialogue, role of women in society and different approaches to the behavior of the children, of the family affairs. We have a special meetings concerned with the cultural exchanges. And all that gave us possibility to host the World Forum for Intercultural Dialogue, which is arranged every second year in Baku. One and among the partners of this World Forum for Intercultural Dialogue are several biggest institutions in the world: United Nations, Alliance of Civilization, UNESCO, ISESCO, Council of Europe, World Tourism Organization. They all are our partners. And seeing all this possibility, it was common decision of the United Nations to held the 7th World Global Forum for Alliance of Civilization in Baku in Azerbaijan, to see these traditions, to use this practice, to feel the mood of the better understanding which exists in our country. That's why I think that in April, late April, in 26th, 27th, we will host the 7th World Global Forum for Alliance of Civilization, and we're expecting very big delegations, including Kuwait, of course. By the way, I would note that during the World Forum for Intercultural Dialogue, during the ministerial meeting, Honorable Minister from Kuwait, Mr. Al-Sabah, was with us. He came to Azerbaijan several times, and we know each other very well, and we exchange always our visions, our plans, our work, and we highly respect the experience of Kuwait in promoting the Islamic values, Islamic traditions, modernity, development of the country. That's why I think that this time Kuwait will also be participating at the global forum on very high level.
Your Excellency, it's interesting to know that Azerbaijan is tying the world together and bringing the various regions and backgrounds, and also not forgetting to bring in a one part melted the culturalism within Azerbaijan. That's very interesting to know that Azerbaijan is not only preserving the environment or the lands or the natural or the history that exists, but also the history of the people that live and has been living all over the Azerbaijan. That's very interesting to know.
Thank you.
Your Excellency, could you tell us what other international events Azerbaijan is holding or will be hosting?
As you know, last year we hold in Azerbaijan the first ever European sports games, which are equal to the Olympic Games of Europe. And it was very successful, and it was the first initiative, first practice. I think that these games gave us very positive impact, because now in Azerbaijan we have the well-developed infrastructure for any competitions which you can imagine, starting with Olympic Games until the small, you know, competition within one sports. The other thing that in 2017, the city of Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, will host the Islamic Solidarity Games. And Islamic Solidarity Games will unite athletes from all Islamic countries which will participate, which will compete in different sport events. We consider that this event will bring not only sports achievements, at the same time it will show the unity of Islamic countries, the use of Islamic countries who are strong, who are healthy, who are goodwill, who want to be in the sports fields to compete with each other, to show their potential. And I think at the same time this event must be the part of the cultural exchange, because this use coming from different part of the world with a different tradition but belonging to Islamic values, they will bring some culture, some behavior, some attitude. And I think that this is very important to put them all together. And I think that this event will be one of the biggest cultural and sport events we ever saw. But this year, we're expecting another interesting challenge. In June, on 17th, 19th June, we will have, first time in our country, Formula One competition within the city. City is preparing now for that, road construction, a lot of precautions and so on. All the city is waiting how this event will happen. And I think it will accept a lot of tourists who are interested in the such kind of events. Generally, every year in Azerbaijan, we have the chain of the multi-international, let's say so, international events, sports competitions, world championships, world cups, the European cups, tournaments in different fields of sports, because our sports infrastructure is very well developed. The other thing that we have every year several international music festivals. We have festival of classical music, we have festival of the maqam music, maqam, which is uniting all the people of the Orient with the throat thinking, with the tradition of the expression. And the other thing that we have, for example, summer plein air musical festivals, and the biggest orchestras of the world are coming there. Biggest, starting with the London Symphonic Orchestra, Johannesburg Orchestra, German orchestras, Russia orchestras coming to play at these festivals. At the same time, we have every year in October, jazz festival. International Jazz Festival, and biggest name of the jazz have been to Baku several times already participating there. All this gives, you know, the possibility for the people who wants to be involved in the cultural sport processes to feel themselves very comfortable in Azerbaijan. We have 26 theaters in the country. Each of them has its own vision, practice, auditorium, separate building. We have numerous museums, starting with the history museum until the art and modern art museums. We have small galleries where we'll find a lot of paintings and artistic works of the young generation, and we have very interesting spaces for creative activity of youth. At the new development of the Baku Boulevard is like your Corniche, but the length is 9, it will be 12 kilometers soon. So people can come, enjoy, express their activity and enjoy life. Azerbaijan is very popular with its gastronomy. The cuisine in Azerbaijan is something very important for our life. In spite of the fact that we have all restaurants of all different cuisines, starting with Indian, Philippines, French, everyone is presented in Baku. But we, of course, consider that the Azerbaijani cuisine is something to be tasted by the guests. We have in every hotel special program concerned with the Azeri breakfast. This is the breakfast which is going to be at the homes in the style, as we used to have. So I think it is another topic to come.
Excellent. It's actually very interesting. We really need to live the culture of Azerbaijan, and I hope to even, if we could bring some part of the culture here to Kuwait to have the people experience. In this regard, how do you see, Your Excellency, cooperation? How can the cooperation take place between Azerbaijan and Kuwait in the field of culture and tourism?
I would like to note that we have very stable background for this relationship, because the state of Azerbaijan and state of Kuwait signed a state agreement between ministries and between states, the governments, about cooperation in the field of tourism and the cooperation in the field of culture. We had very successful days of culture of Kuwait in Azerbaijan in 2013. We had very interesting presentations of Azeri culture here in Kuwait. And I think that after our meeting with His Excellency the Minister, we will push forward to start again this contacts and send artists and musicians and people of art to Kuwait to participate at different events here. And we're of course waiting for active participation of Kuwaiti young generation, well-known people of art, people of science in the events which we held in Azerbaijan. From this point of view, I think that the experience of the cultural capital of Islamic world, which was Baku 2009. Now I know that the Kuwait is the cultural capital of Islamic world. And in 2018, the city of Nakhichevan in Azerbaijan will be again the cultural capital of Islamic world. These exchanges within these programs will give a lot of positive impact, because we can exchange the routes, we can bring more people. Concerning the cooperation of tourism, I can say that our negotiations considered to be very successful. We are thinking about opening the direct flight between the two countries to start this operation, because this will initiate the volume of the people. The distance between the two countries is the closest among all the Khalij countries. It is only 1 hour and 45 minutes flight from Kuwait to Baku. So I think that it is a good possibility. And I would like to announce today in front of the spectators of the TV that Azerbaijan announced the free access like a tourist for all the citizens of the GCC countries. You can acquire visa either through internet in advance or through embassy, but at the same time you can take the ticket, you can come to Baku, you can come to any airport in Azerbaijan to get visa in the airport and go inside. The price of visa for tourists is only $20, so it is not the price which is under discussion. So I mean the same possibilities we arranged for the citizens of GCC countries, and at the same time the countries of Far East, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, so all they also can acquire the visa at the airport.
Toward the end of our special program and show with you, Your Excellency, are there any other information you like to share with us, or any other ideas you like to let us know?
I think that it's better to see once than to listen many times. It's better to taste the food than to hear about that. But at the same time, I can say that the habits and the style of life in Kuwait and in Azerbaijan are very resembling each other. During this day, one day I could see a lot of people living, enjoying life, enjoying beautiful places, the Corniche, walking, how they are free, how they are positively living their style, you know. I think it was something uniting our nations, and I think that every Kuwaiti citizen who will come to Azerbaijan will not feel himself abroad. He will feel himself as he is at home.
Your Excellency, thank you very, very much for joining us and also inviting us to visit Azerbaijan. We look forward for other meetings, and we thank you very, very much for joining us on Kuwait TV. Dear viewers, on behalf of you and the team, we thank our Minister of Culture and Tourism, His Excellency Abulfaz Krayaf. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.